Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 66th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 10-3. The booster which launched this mission, B-1062, then became the first booster to land for a 22nd time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then, a couple of days later, and SpaceX successfully launched their 67th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 186. The booster which launched this mission, B-1081, then landed successfully for the 8th time on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see at least one Starlink mission to launch. The Starlink 8-9 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 3rd at 6:01 a.m. UTC or 2:01 a.m. EST. There was some interesting news posted by NASA with SpaceX being awarded almost $1 billion for a mission. It says, "We have selected SpaceX to develop and deliver the US deorbit vehicle and prepare for a safe and responsible deorbit of the space station after the end of its operational life in 2030. Alex from NSF posted some information about another payload that SpaceX will launch on a Falcon 9. It says, "Looks like another European satellite went from Ariane 6 to SpaceX's Falcon 9. In this case, this one is the second satellite of Europe's latest generation of geostationary weather satellites. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the Launch Tower 2 sections. Here's a look at the work continuing to progress on the orbital launch pad B. The crane to stack the pad B launch tower was seen rising. Two more tower sections as well as chopstick pieces were seen arriving from the Cape. As SpaceX continued to scrap old tank farm tanks, a forward dome fell and broke apart. Work continues on the new office building at Starbase. SpaceX posted a video related to B14.1 and chopstick catch testing. They said Starbase team testing the tower chopsticks for the upcoming catch of a super heavy booster. Here's another look at some of that chopstick catch testing. A SpaceX engineer responded to a post about how the team feels about successfully catching a super heavy booster. It says the whole team is feeling pretty good about it. The water landing for booster 11 was very accurate. After the testing of the B14.1 test tank, it was removed from the orbital launch mount. The work to replace Starship 30's heat shield tiles is continuing. To finish up the video today, SpaceX currently have a few temporary closures for today, Sunday 30th through to Tuesday 2nd. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.